So, I don't know if you guys are up to date on the news, but I watch The Daily Show, so I get a little bit of it, and, most of it, and, apparently Newt Gingrich's wife came out and said that she, at one point, he wanted to have an open relationship, which I've been thinking about constantly, because to me it's amazing that Newt Gingrich was, like, sitting around, like, God damn it! I can get so much pussy! Oh, God! Fuck my wife! And, like, I just can't imagine, like be the girl, like, Newt late at night, like, working, like, I'm going home, I'm tired.
Hey, Newt.
Oh. What?
Do you want to come home?
Oh, damn it, I'm married, damn it!
We could play intern.
Oh, Jesus. Talk to my wife about this. So, I just like it. I just try to put snares over and over in my head of, like, women coming on to Newt Gingrich. I suggest you do it, too. So up next, we've got James Betts.
James motherfucker.
Can we all hear it for James Betts? James Betts in the house. Is James Betts. We just keep forgetting about the comedians.
I know he's here. I'm going to go get him.
All right. I'll just stay here. All right. Oh, thanks. Take a mic.
Yeah, take it. Have him start over there.
All right. Does anyone have any questions they want to ask or anything they wanted to say?
Can you describe James Betts first before he comes out?
He's a very awesome guy, and he's another guy I've had my eye on for a while. I never thought he would be.
If you guys can hear me, but I'm in the bar now, and I'm looking for James.
This is pretty amazing.
Hey, where's James? Yeah. You're on stage right now.
I'm on stage right now? I'm on stage. I'm struggling with Brian Nichols. Talking about bullshit.
This is what it feels like to watch SNL.
Okay.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, James Betts.
Fucking lie. One, two, all neurotypicals are assholes. Three, Wolf is a sellout. Thanks.
You never know quite what you're gonna get at the Wham City County Night. Alright, so.
Miss James Betts
segment. It was really good.
Anybody take notes?
Video. Anyway, so Mason and I didn't get that chance we like to go backstage and come up with what we're gonna say. So we've got nothing at this point, which is fine. We'll just introduce the last comedian, which we're also extremely excited about.
This is great. This next comedian.
I couldn't have said it any better. he's been sitting out there with, like, almost like he's writing his thesis. Just papers all around him like a mad scientist. It's his triumphant return to the stage. He's been gone for over a year from doing comedy. He's been studying in the mountains, meditating. Just kind of meditating on comedy.
What are those mountains?
They're like the Alps, the Swiss Alps?
Yeah!
The Swiss Alps?
Yeah!
I got it right. Thanks, Adam. I'm not a Swiss Alps teacher. I don't teach because those
are geography.
I'm an artist. Okay.
There are no Swiss Alps.
You said something stupid too. Swills Mason. Come on.
All right.
Enough of this.
Yeah, right?
Let's introduce, and I almost can't even say his name. Showbiz.
No, please, sit down. Sit down. What's this? I don't know. Okay, so I'd like to thank all the comics and the hosts for oiling the spokes, so to speak. You're all probably wondering where I've been. And the truth is, Showbiz fell into a deep cybernation in which I had an epic dream, whereupon I went on a world tour. First up was in beautiful Venezuela. I shouted my jokes from atop the world's tallest waterfall. Each joke fell 3,000 feet to its death. I, however, am of the belief that the trees just didn't understand anything I was saying. They are Mexican, after all. Showbiz! Thank you. Next up was Peru, where I encountered a shaman and drank some ayahuasca. Afterwards, I encountered an insectoid intelligence in a parallel universe. Showbiz. So, I hightailed it up to Canada, where, of course, after the show, I got in another hockey fight. Showbiz. On my way down to Antarctica, I got a text from Steve Jobs. It said, "Hell is full of internet trolls." So I responded, I said, "You wait until you're dead to call your grandmother back? You're a horrible grandson, Stephen." Showbiz. Call your grandmother.
She's dead.
Well, text her then. Thank you. So anyway, my show in Antarctica. The only audience members were a polar bear and a couple ice cubes. I'd say it went pretty well. Went pretty well, man. I got eaten alive. No beer. I once mixed up my Old Spice with my old bay. My armpits smelled like a crab hammer, and my lunch tasted like a job interview. Showbiz! I once mixed up my wheat with my weed. Suffice to say, after 3 days of trying to stuff pumpernickel in a peace pipe, I was toasted. Showbiz! So my sailor friend, while he was coming to town, he asked me to show him a good time. So I says, "Well, okay, well, when would be a good time?" Yeah. No, seriously, show me, sir. My sailor friend, he came to visit me last week and asked me to show him the ropes. So I showed him the ropes. But he overwhelmingly preferred the monkey bars. Now, I try not to judge my sailor friend for having one-night stands with chimps. Because I myself harbor secretive, shameful sexual perversions. Showbiz! I met a pretty young thing the other night. Went so well, we went back to her place to seal the deal. It was a total success. We spent hours just barking and clapping and balancing a ball on our noses. Show me. Thank you. I once mixed up seals. Crazy perverted stuff, I tell you. I once mixed up my hen with my pen. My scribbles became squabbles, and my yolk was a joke. Showbiz! That one's for Egg Schrader. I once mixed up my iron with my siren. I learned two very important things. One, you can't iron pants with sound. And two, if you're running down the street, waving an iron and screaming for help, it doesn't matter how disheveled your clothes look. Lopez! I don't know. You see, most men try to wear the pants in their relationships. I, on the other hand, choose to wear my relationship in my pants. Unfortunately, that means my feelings are quite often left in the dark. Slow burner, biz! Showbiz's jokes fly like arrows. Fruit flies like a tomato. But I can't see how a banana would be more appealing. Showbiz tells grown-up jokes. You groan while I'm up here. Got time for a couple more?
Yeah!
Well, what kind of pants do goats wear? Bleeding ones! You know what really gets my goat? My goat's therapist! So I was thinking the other day that I would really like to have just a perfect mold of my ass made, and then having it handed to me on a silver platter. Showbiz is privileged. Okay, so the other day I went apartment hunting, and I totally mutilated this one bedroom, a quaint little one bedroom. You know, those things are really hard to catch. That joke's still in the works. Showbiz is going green. I accidentally pissed on my copper leg. You know what? Thank you very much, folks. You've been great. Oh, Showbiz!
Showbiz, Showbiz! Showbiz is really captured a certain je ne sais quoi. Let's hear it for that je ne sais quoi. I was just remarking to Ben that when Showbiz performs, it's like a heroin addiction. Because while he's telling the joke, I just want it. And I want to hear the punchline, I just really want it. But in between jokes, I just know that it's bad for me. Thank you guys for coming to the episode. Let's hear it for, let's go through the night. This is always hard for me. Ahmed, Carrie Dursick, Owen Bement, and then Craig Coletta, Nolan Straws, James Pets, and Showbiz!